चक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं साक्षात्कृतं दयानंदं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्वज्ञान प्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ओम सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। You can repeat. येन रूपं रसं गन्धम्
येन रूपं रसं गन्धम्
शब्दान् स्पर्शांश्च मैथुनान्
शब्दान् स्पर्शांश्च मैथुनान्
एतेनैव विजानाति
एतेनैव विजानाति
किमत्र परिशिष्यते
किमत्र परिशिष्यते
एतद्वैतत् स्वप्नान्तं जागरितान्तं
जागरितान्तं
शोभोगेनानुपश्यति
शोभोगेनानुपश्यति
महान्तं विभुमात्मानम्
महान्तं विभुमात्मानम्
मत्वा धीरो न शोचति
मत्वा धीरो न शोचति
ययिमं मध्वदं वेद
ययिमं मध्वदं वेद
आत्मानं जीवमन्तिकात्
आत्मानं जीवमन्तिकात्
ईशानं भोक्तव्यस्य
ईशानभूतभव्यस्य
ततो विजुगुप्सते
ततो विजुगुप्सते
एतद्वैतत्
एतद्वैतत्
पास्वर्ड् इस् करेक्ट् नौ द मीटिङ्ग् पास्वर्ड् वाट् ऐ सेण्ट् यू
करेक्ट् ओन्ली वी गाट् द लैन्
Sandeep ji has sent a message saying it incorrect password.
Correct.
A message. यः पूर्वं तपसो जातम् अद्यः पूर्वमजायत गुहां प्रविश्य तिष्ठन्तम् यो भूतेभिर्व्यपश्यत या प्राणेन संभवति
आदितेर्देवतामही
गुहां प्रविश्य तिष्ठन्ति या भूतेभिर्व्यजायत एतद्वैतत् अरण्योर्निगितो जातवेदाः गर्भ इव सुभृतो गर्भिणीभिः दिवे दिवहीड्यो जागृवद्भिः विष्मद्भिर्मनुष्येभिरग्निः एतद्वैतत् यतश्चोदेति सूर्यः अस्तं यत्र च गच्छति तं देवा सर्वे अर्पिताः तदुनात्येति कश्चन एतद्वैतत् यदेवेकतदमुत्र यदमुत्र तदन्विह मृत्यो समृत्यमाप्नोति ऐहनानेव पश्यति मनसैवेदमाप्तव्यम् नास्ति किञ्चन मृत्यो समृत्यं गच्छति यैह नानेव पश्यति The next mantra, which we have seen the Bhashyam also. We can read the mantra, quickly read the Bhashyam also. Punarapi tadeva prakritam brahma aha.
Punarapi tadeva prakritam brahma aha.
Angushtamatrav purushaha. मध्य आत्मनि तिष्ठति ईशानो भूत भव्यस्य ततो विजुगुप्सते एतद्वैतत् We have seen this mantra. This mantra is also a Mahavakya This mantra says that the Atma which is obtained in the mind, the mind Hridaya, which is the Upalabdhi Sthanam for Atma. When we say Upalabdhi Sthanam, which is recognized in the mind, not that it is located in the mind, located in the heart. Hridaya Pundarikam, Hridaya Pundarike Tishtati, which is obtained in the Hridaya Pundarika, in the heart, when we say it is recognized, it is appreciated in the heart, in the mind, mind or heart. It is not a physical heart. The Goloka is not a physical one. Atma being Sarvavyapi, Sarvagataha, so therefore Upalabdhi Sthanam is, doesn't confine the Atma to a particular place. It is not located. Its location is not confined to only the heart alone. It is Upalabdhi Sthanam. Atmanaha Upalabdhi Sthanam. Atmanaha Upalabdhi Sthanam Hridaya Pundarikam iti. Hridaya Pundarike, and Hridaya Pundarika has got a parimana, has got a size, the measurement, which is Angushtamatraha. Angushtamatraha, Angushta Parimanam, of the size of Angushta. Angushta is thumb. The size of the thumb is a space. The space in the heart. The heart which has got the space, and the space is of the size of Angushta. So Hridaya Chidram, that is Manushya Hridaya Chidram, Tadantarvarti, and the Atma is located in that. Antakkarana Upadikaha Angushta Parimanaha Purushaha. Because it is a Upadi, therefore, Antakkarana being a Upadi, and Atma being obtained, recognized in the Antakkarana, and the Antakkarana is Hridaya Pundarika, or Hridaya Chidram, the space of the heart, the cavity of the heart, Hridaya Guha. This Purusha, which is Purnaha, which is Sarvatra Purnaha, Purushaha, that Sarvavyapi, that Purnaha, Purav Ushati iti Purushaha, Purav Ushati Purishete iti Purushaha, Purnatvat Purushaha, that Purusha, that Atma, which is Purnaha, is located, is appreciated. And this Hridaya Guha, which is of the size of the thumb, in that this Atma, this Sarvavyapi Atma is Upalabdha. Therefore, Atma is of the size of the thumb. Angushta Matra, Matraha Purushaha. So, therefore, this Atma, which is Brahma, this Atma, the Jivatma, is not different from Paramatma. Paramatmanaha na bhinnaha. Ataha na vijugupsate. Therefore, it doesn't have any need to seek security. Because being the very meaning of the word security, it doesn't seek anything else. Purnatva, being complete. Therefore, there is no wanting. There is no wanting for this Atma. There is no pressure to hunt for Dharma Purusharta, Kama Purusharta, Moksha Purusharta. Because Moksha Swarupatvat Na Vijugupsate, the Atma doesn't seek security anymore. So this Atma is that what you ask for Nachiketa, Etat Dvaitat. And the first line talks about the Tvam Padartha. Tvam Padartha, that is Tvam Padartha, and the Lakshyartha of the first line is Chaitanyam. And it is called by the name Purushaha. And this Purushaha, the Atma, Madhye Atmani Tishtati. Madhye Atmani. Here Atmani, we saw Atmani means the body. Atmani is body. In the body, it is Tishtati, it resides in the body. And what is its size? Parimana, Angushta Matraha. Angushtasya Matraiva Matrasya. Matrasya Purushasya. It is of the size of the thumb. How can the all-pervading Atma can be the size of the thumb, if you ask? Because since it is obtained in the Antakaranam, as what? Aham Aham Iti Sada. Aham Aham Iti Vritti Rupena Upalabdaha. Therefore, in the Hridaya Akasha, it is present. And the Hridaya Akasha is of the size of the thumb. Therefore, Hridaya Akasha, the cavity, the space, in the Antakaranam, it is of the size of the thumb, where the Atma is Upalabdaha. Therefore, Atma is said to be of the size of the Angushta. Angushta Matraha. Matra here means size, of the size. Matra is in the sense of Mana, the measurement, Ma. Pramane Matra Chipratya is used, therefore, the size here. Matra doesn't mean only here. Matra has got another meaning as avya. It means only, but that is not the meaning here. Here matra means size. Ma. Matrach pratyaya. Pramane matrach. Why this mantra says that Atma is of the size of the sum of the thumb located in the cavity? It is for meditation, upasana. It is for upasana. Doing upasana of Atma in the Hridaya Akasha, the person gets better phalam. Doesn't give moksha. It gives certain phalam. Upasana gives phalam which is far greater than karma. There is a gradation. When a karma is converted to a upasana, it gives better phalam. Karma gives phalam. And the karma, if it is converted to upasana, then it gives better phalam. And the upasana is converted. The form of jnanam. Then it gives moksha. So, upasana. Upasana gives chitta naishchalyam. That is required for jnanam, jnana yogyata. So therefore it is prescribed as the method upasana for the upasakas. And this Atma, this Purusha, who is Bhuta Bhavyasya, Ishanaha Bhuta Bhavyasya. He is the Bhuta. Bhuta is past. Bhavya is what is going to be, what is going to come. Bhavya. Bhuta Bhavyasya Vartamanasya Api. Bhuta Vartam Bhutasya Vartamanasya Bhavishyasya Api Ishanaha. He is a lord of all the three periods of time. So, Bhuta Bhavyasya, when we say, Ishanaha, is Paramatma, and in the first line it was Purushaha, which is Tvam Padartha, that is Tvam, the Lakshyata of the word Tvam is Atma, Purushaha. Ishanaha Bhuta Bhavyasya, here Tat Padartha, and the Lakshyata of the Tat Padartha is Ishvara. So therefore, that Atma which is located in the Hridaya Guha, Hridaya Chidram, is Ishanaha, who is the Lord of all the three periods of time. Therefore, it is Mahavakyam. Purushaha is Ishanaha. Purusha, which is Madhye Atmani Tishtati, Aspin Sharire, Hridaya Guhayam, Angushta Matraha, Iva Angushta Matraha Tishtati, Yaha Purushaha, Saha, Bhuta Bhavyasya Ishanaha. Therefore, it is Mahavakyam. So, Tvam Pada Purushaha, it is equated to Tat Pada Ishvaraha. Tvam Pada is resolved into Tat Pada Akshyartha. Therefore, it is Mahavakyam. Tat Tvam Asi. This Atma, this Chaitanyam Purusha is the truth of Ishanaha. Therefore, knowing this, understanding this, understanding Jiveshwara Aikyam, Aham At Ishvara, Ishvarat Na Bindaha, I am Ishvara, Jagatkaranam Brahma, Ishvaraha, Aham Asmi, Iti, Nyatva, Viditva. Knowing this, what will a person seek in life? What is there to seek in life? If you are Jagatkaranam Brahma Ishvara, if this truth is known, you are Ishvara, Ishvara being everything, what will be there for the person? What will be there for the person to seek in life? For what he has to work? He doesn't have any wanting. He doesn't need any protection. He doesn't need any security. He doesn't seek any comfort because he is the meaning of the very word comfort. He is the meaning of the very word shanti. He is the meaning of the word security. Therefore, na vijugupsate. In fact, he becomes the source of security for everything. He becomes a source of security for others. That is why people worship jnanis. Because jnani tu atma iva mematam iti Bhagavan Krishna says in the Gita. Jnani is myself, being one with the Lord. Therefore, people seek security in the jnani. He becomes a source of security for others. So therefore, this is a beautiful mantra. Mahavakya mantra. Mahavakya need not be only the four Mahavakya from four Vedas. This is also every mantra in this chapter is a Mahavakya. It is fit for doing Nididhyasana. Mantra, the mantra doesn't give any new information. No Upanishads give any new information. You cannot seek new information. Upanishad talks or gives, presents the same truth. The same truth it presents through the different methods, different words. The truth is one. The same truth presented through different words, different mantras, different Upadhi, Samashti Upadhi or Vyashti Upadhi. We saw previously it was presented through Hiranyagarbha, Sukshma Sharira Upadhi, Samashti Sukshma Sharira Upadhi. Similarly, Samashti Stula Sharira Upadhi Dwara. This Aikyam was presented. Different ways of presenting the Aikyam, but the truth is Aikyam. Therefore, all these mantras are fit for doing Nididhyasana. Therefore, to seek new information or to be to say that mantras are the Upanishad, the second chapter of this Upanishad, unlike the first chapter being a story, therefore people will be more interested in the story. But here there is no story. It talks about the Tattvam. It is about Nididhyasana. We have grown up to understand the Tattvam, and we have grown up enough to understand, to meditate, to do Nididhyasana on the Tattvam. Therefore, you should not think the mantras are boring, because there may be a tendency when the Upanishad repeats the same thing. There may be a tendency to think the mantras are a bit dragging or boring. It is not. It is for doing Nididhyasana. Makavakyas are present. We have to see the Makavakya in the mantra. When you read the mantra, when you study the mantra with Dibhasham, appreciate that Upanishad talks about me, and that Aham Jagat Karana Brahma. When this is understood, then all the problems, all the samsarika problems will reduce to nothing. It's nothing. Therefore, all these mantras are beautiful mantras, important mantras. And Bhashyakara already he had presented, he had written Bhashya for all the mantras. Therefore, here also he had same Mahavakyam. Therefore, he just gives a simple meaning of the words of the mantra. Doesn't write any further in detail. There is no Purva Pakshi and all. A simple Bhashyam. That also I think we saw in the last class. You can read quickly the Bhashyam. Angushtamatraha.
Angushtamatraha.
Angushtaparimanaha.
Angushtaparimanaha.
Angushtamatraha is equal to Angushtaparimanaha. Matraha is Parimana, the measurement. So Angushtasya Parimanam Iva. Angushta parimanam, angushta size, the size of the thumb. So it is only eva, as like the size of the thumb. Angushta parimanaha. Angushta parimanam.
Angushta parimanam.
Hridaya pundarikam.
Hridaya pundarikam.
Tachidra varti.
Tathachidravarti
Antakarana Upadihi
Antakarana Upadihi
Angushta Matraha
Angushta Matraha
Angushta Matra Vamsha Parva Madhyavarti Ambharavat
Angushta Matra Vamsha Parva Madhyavarti Ambharavat
Angushta Parimanam, which is Hridaya Pundarikam. Hridaya Pundarika means lotus. Hridaya Pundarika, lotus heart. Heart is like the lotus. In the lotus heart, there is Angushta Parimanam of the size of the thumb. There is a space, Chidra. So, Hridaya Pundarikam, Hridayam Pundarikam Iva, Hridaya Pundarikam, lotus-like art, Tachidravarti Antakrana Upadihi. Tachidravarti Antakrana Upadihi. Antakrana Upadihi, the Purusha, the Atma, which has the Antakrana as the Upadhi, and the Antakarana is the Hridaya Pundarika, and it has got Chidra, the space. Chidravarti has got space. Chidra is space. And the space is like that of the the space. The space in the vamsha. Vamsha is bamboo. Angushta matra vamsha. The space in the within the section of the bamboo vamsha. The bamboo tree, the bamboo will have knots. And that is called parva, the section. Parva means section. Vamsha is bamboo. The bamboo which has got the sections, it has got many sections. And each section, is formed by the two the knots will be there. Knot like thing, knots. So, therefore, this the space in the hollow section between the two knots, like that, it's a figurative, langushta matraha, the space obtaining within the section of the bamboo. So, angushta matraha, eva. So, like the space within the section of the bamboo tree, ambaravat, the space. Like the space. Who is this angushta matraha? Is the purushaha. So purushaha.
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 Purnam anena sarvam iti.
Purnam anena sarvam iti.
Purnam anena sarvam iti. Anena sarvam purnam. Anena sarvam purnam, by which everything is purna, everything is complete, everything is pervaded. By which everything is pervaded. What is that by which everything is pervaded? Purushaha, Atma Chaitanya. Puryate sarvam anena iti purushaha. That which fills up everything, pervades everything, that is purushaha. And this purushaha is madhye atmani.
Atmani
is equal to Sharire Tishtati.
Sharire Tishtati.
Yahatam Atmanam.
Yahatam
Atmanam.
Ishanam.
Ishanam.
Bhuta Bhavyasya Viditva.
Bhuta Bhavyasya Viditva.
Na. Not tataha. It should be tataha. In the moolam, it is tataha. Not that is a typo. Not tataha.
Not tataha.
It's a mistake. Okay. Ityadi. Not pirvavat. It's also a typo. Purvavat.
Ityadi. Purvavat.
Etadvaitat is there. Therefore, purvavat. This is what you ask for Nachiketa, that we have to supply from the previous mantra. Not immediately previous, it has gone before. Na Purvavata, not Pirvavata, it's a typo. Na Tataha Ityadi Purvavata. So, this Atma, Madhye Atmani Sharire Tishtati. This Atma which is Sharire Tishtati. Yaha, the one. Tam Atmanam Ishanam. Bhashyakara gives. Atmanam is Ishanam. Atmanam is Ishanam. Who that Atma, which is Ishanam, Ishanam of Bhuta Bhavyasya, the Lord of the past, the present, Kalatresya, Kalatresya Ishanam. That is the one who is existence. Trikale yat tishtati tat sat sat swarupa chit swarupa ananda swarupa sachidananda swarupa brahma satyam jnanam anantam brahma tam tat brahma which is atma brahmaatmanam viditva gyatva tat how shastra dvarena guru mukhat shavana shastra dvarena Viditva, Jnatva, Natataha, Ityadi, Purvavata. Viditva, Jnatva, Navijigupsate. He doesn't seek any security ityadi ityadi purvavati etadvaitat we have to supply etadvaitat that is which is in the previous mantra na etadvaitat iti so therefore this atma which is tishtati sharire sharira madhye tishtati sakshi rupena sarva sakshitaya tishtati atmani sharire and this atma is bhuta bhavyasya bhuta vartamana bhavishyasya kalatrayasya ishanaha is the isha the lord is the niyamaka the order is the order of is the order is the ruler of the world of ruler of the time itself is mithya so time it is there in the vyavahara time means space so everything for everything is the lord of everything time and space covers everything the whole jagat so tam atmanam tam brahmaatmanam viditva jnatva then after that atma jnanat urdvam na vijigupsate atmanam rakshitam na icchati he doesn't seek to protect himself because he being the niyamaka understanding the ishana so therefore na rakshitam icchati vidyugupsate means na rakshitam icchati he becomes the source of security for others so therefore na vidyugupsate iti etadvaitat so yat nachiketasa prishtam atmatattvam tat etat eva tat uktam tat एतत् उक्त स्वरूपमेव इति एतद्वै तत् पूर्ववत् इति भाष्यकारः सेस् नाउ कंटिन्यूइंग द नेक्स्ट मंत्र किंच अंगुष्ठमात्रः पुरुषः ज्योतिरिवाधूमकः ईशानो भूतभव्यस्य सयेवाद्यसहुष्वः एतद्वैतत् दिस् इस् आल्सो ए महावाक्य मंत्र लाइक द प्रीवियस मंत्र The first part is same. Angushta matraha purushaha. This purusha who is of the size of the angushta. Angushta matraha purushaha. Taha purushaha jyotihi iva. Jyotihi iva. Angushta matraha angushta parimanaha purushaha purnaha purushaha jyotihi iva. ज्योतिः इव अधूमकः धूमा मीन्स् स्मोक् अधूमकः 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 इस् अधूमकम् दट् इस् धूमरहितं धूमरहितम् इत्यर्थः इट् इस् डजन्ट् हाव् स्मोक् दिस् पुरुष हु इस् ए ज्योति ए लैट् And it is a light without a smoke. A light without the smoke. Adhumakaha. Jyotihi iva prakashaha. Jyotihi iva prakashaha asti. Vartamanaha. Into dhumaragitaha. Dhumaragitaha. Jyotihi. A jyoti, a light will have smoke. A light will have smoke. Any light. Light means Agni. Agni is there. When Agni is there, smoke will be there. When a flame is there, smoke will be there, but this Atma, Svayam Prakasha Atma, Prakashaka Atma, is a light. It is very bright, and that bright light doesn't have smoke. Here smoke means, smoke is the upadhi. So, adumakaha jyotihi purusha means nirupadika purushaha nirupadika chaitanyam ityartha. Nirupadika chaitanyam. The atma, the purusha doesn't have upadhi. It is free from upadhi. Upadhi ragitaha. That is called nirupada, nirupadika, nirupadika chaitanyam. With the shariram, it is sopadika. Without upadhi, nirupadika. Upadhi is required for recognizing, for appreciating the chaitanyam. The chaitanyam manifests through the shariram. Without shariram doesn't mean chaitanyam is not there. Chaitanyam being all pervading, it is there. Its swarupam is nirupadika swarupam. So nirupadika chaitanya, nirguna chaitanya, that is the meaning. The chaitanyam which is free from upadhi. Upadhivat prakashate, as though with the upadhi. With the upadhi only the transaction is possible. And the upadhi is mithya. The upadhi, the truth of upadhi is also chaitanyam only. First we present Atma, Anatma. As though there are two things are there, Atma, Anatma. Atma, Anatma, Viveka. Atma is there, Chaitanyam. Anatma is there, Jada. Jada Vastu. So we present, we separate into two things, the Jagat into Atma and Anatma. Atma Vastu, Anatma Vastu. Atma being Chaitanya, the consciousness. What is Anatma? If Anatma also has got a separate parallel reality, then the truth is Dvaitam, not Advaitam. But Anatma is also Atma only. What is Anatma? Nama Rupakatvat Nitya. Now, Nama Rupa is Nama Rupatmaka Jagat is Jagat. Anatma is Mithya. Therefore, Satyam is Atma alone. Therefore, the division also is dissolved in the wake of Jnanam. In the beginning, that Viveka is required, but later you will see that Anatma also is Atma only. Like the example, the actor A is B. The actor A playing the role of the beggar B. The B is A, but A cannot be B. Only the drama, the actor plays the role of beggar. But actor A is always A only. B is A, but A is not B. Same thing here also. So, nirupadika chaitanyam. Smokeless chaitanyam means nirupadika chaitanyam. Ishana Bhutabhavyasya. Ishanaha, the Lord, like the previous mantra. Trikalasya Bhutabhavyasya Ishanaha. Kalatrayasya Ishanaha. Ishvaraha Saha. So, Saha Ishanaha. Ishvaraha Saha Ishanaha. Saha Yeva. Saheva Adhya Taushvaha. Saha Eva Adhya. Adhya referring to today. Saha Eva Adhya. Adhya is today. Adhya. Vartamane. Vartamana Kale. Adhya. Adhya is Vartamana Kale. Saha Eva Atma. Adhya Vartamana Kale. Pranishu Vartate. The one who is present in the Prani. Now. Saha. Sa U. Shvaha, who is particle. Saha eva atma, shvaha. Shvaha is tomorrow. That is the kala, the time which has to come. Shvaha. Agami Kala. Agami Kala, that is the time, the period which has to come. That is Bhavishya. The one who is now here in the Prani is the one who will be there tomorrow. Sagevadhyaya Savushvaha. Yaha Adhyaya Saha Eva Adhyaya Saha Shvaha Api. So the one who is now, he continues to be there Shvaha, tomorrow also. So therefore, Adhya Shvaha. But the time is dismissed. Mithya. The time is Mithya. Therefore, there is no time also. So, Angushta Matra, Angushta Sadrusha, Purushaha, Jyotihi, like light, Jyotihi, Iva, Adhumakaha, Jyotihi, the word Jyotihi is interesting word. Jyutyate anena iti Jyotihi. Something by which a thing is illumined, that is called Jyotihi. Dyutyate, or we can say that is a dhatu, jyut dhatu is there. Jyutyate anena iti Jyotihi. That is that in the presence of which something is illumined. It's called Jyotihi. So it is Karana Vyutpatti. You can take Jyutyate, where Jyutyate, when you say Jakara Adesha happens in the place of Dakara. So you get Jyutyate, or there is a Dhatu Jyut. So Jyutyate Anena Iti Jyotihi also can be taken. So that in the presence of which something is illumined, that is called Jyotihi. That is called Jyotihi, the light. The light is there. Light need not be a physical light. That is light in the eye. Our the sense organ, the chakshus, has got eyes. The light of, because of the light of the eyes, the objects are illumined. The objects are available for perception, for vision. So there is a Jyoti in the eye. There's a Jyoti in the nose. Because of that only, the objects are available for perception. All the sense organs, all the Pancha Gyanendriya have got this Jyoti. Yogindriya has got the Jyoti, the light. Tvak Jyoti, because of which there is an experience, there is an illumination of the sense of touch. So, therefore, Jyoti. Because of this, the light, something is perceived or recognized. This is Indriya Jyoti. This is Indriya Jyoti. Similarly, all Indriya Jyotis are backed up by Mano Jyoti. The light in the mind. All the objects are illumined. So there are Jyotis at three levels. One is Bhagya Jyoti, outside light. Outside light like the Surya or any artificial light. Surya Jyotihi or Jyotihi, any artificial light like Vidyut Deepaha, the light, the lamp. Agra Deepaha, torch light, that is also a Jyoti. All these are Bhagya Jyoti. And there are Mano Jyoti or Indriya Jyoti. That is also Jyoti, the light. The light means knowledge. The knowledge of a thing is gained because of which, that is Jyotihi. And there is one Jyoti because of which everything is illumined. What is that Jyoti? Atma Jyoti. So, Atma is the ultimate light. Bhagya Jyoti has got Dhuma. Antara Jyoti, Mano Jyoti, Atma Jyoti, they don't have Dhuma, but their Jyotis are also not really belonging to them alone. They have got that light, it's a borrowed light. Borrowed from where? Borrowed from Atma. Atma Jyoti. And Atma Jyoti is ultimate Jyoti because of which everything is illumined and doesn't have any smoke. No Upadhi. Upadhi Rakita. Because Manas has got Upadhi. Indriyas are got Upadhi. And Atma doesn't have any Upadhi. Nirupadika Chaitanyam. And this Atma, which is the jyoti. Adumakaha jyoti is napumsakalinga, jyotis. So adumakaha can be taken as adumakam. Upanishad uses pullinga, adumakaha. Adumakaha jyotiki eva atma. Atma is like a smoke plus like nirupadika chaitanyam. Even though it is obtained in Antakarana it is obtained, but still it's free from upadhi. That is why Antakaranam, that Hridaya Pundarikam, is Upalabdhisthana. It doesn't limit the Atma. You cannot limit the Atma by the upadhi. The problem is confining the Atma to the upadhi. That is a problem. Therefore, only the sense of limitation. That is because of the upadhi abhimana, sharira abhimana. Sharira abhimana, agam. Agam mama iti, that abhi, mama, it, that is, this belongs to me, this time, I, ahankara, agam mama, iti ahankara, mamakara, because of this abhimana with this mithya sharira. And this atma, which is this paramatma, brahma, it is free from upadhi, nirupadika, surupa, surupatvat. Therefore, this atma, this Ishanaha, the Lord, who is not limited by time. When upadhi is not there, where is time? Time is free from time. The paramatma, it is in the form of time, the kala and desha and vastu. He is in the form of kala, desha, vastu. But the truth of kala, desha, vastu is paramatma. He is not limited. Paramatma is not limited by the time. And the paramatma is purushaha. The Lord who is obtained in time, who is obtained in desha, who is obtained in vastu, who is the very truth of this, is not limited by time, it's not limited by space, it's not limited by vastu. Desha kala vastu aparichinnaha paramatma ishanaha purushaha jyotihi va dhumakaha purushaha. Therefore bhuta bhavya, all the time is also nitya only. It is a upadhi. It is also upadhi only. Time is there only in the Vyavaharika. Paramarthika drishtya, there is no time. So, therefore, the Lord of even time is Bhagavan. So therefore adhya. Therefore, because time is there, therefore adhya. Timeless. The timelessness is presented. The timelessness of Paramatma is presented by the Upanishad as that Atma alone is adhya. Adhya is now, present now, where in all the upadhis of the jivas, sarveshu praneshu, which is adhya, which is present, upadhishu, which is present now, adhya, that atma is going to be there shvaha, tomorrow. So, that atma is there, is going to be there tomorrow. So, what is today and what is tomorrow is the same Paramatma Ishanaha Iti. Therefore, the timelessness of the Ishvara is presented. Now we can read the Vibhashyam. Angushta Matraha Purushaha.
Angushta Matraha Purushaha.
Jyotihi iva adhumakaha.
Jyotihi iva adhumakaha.
Adhumakam iti yuktam.
Adhumakam iti yuktam.
Jyotihi paratvat.
Jyotihi paratvat.
Jyotis shabda. Therefore, when you do something, jyotish paratvat. Jyotihi paratvat. We do split it. So here, Bhashyakara says, Angushtamatraha Purushaha, this Angushtamatra Purusha, the Atma, the Purusha, which is of the size of Angushta, the thumb, is Adumakaha, na Dumakaha, Dumaragitaha. that is free from Dhuma. The light which is free from Dhuma. Adhumakaha Jyotihi. Adhumakaha qualifying Jyotihi. Jyotihi is what linga? It is Napumsaka linga. Therefore, Adhumakaha, if it is the qualifier, adjective to the Napumsaka linga Shabda, it must be Adhumakam. Jyoti, Jyotis Shabda. Napumsaka linga. Sakaranta Napumsaka linga Shabda. And if the Visheshana is Adhumakaha, how can it can be Adhumakaha? It must be, it also must be a Napumsaka linga Shabda only. Therefore, Bhashyakara says Adhumakam iti yuktam. Therefore, Shruti says Adhumaka. Shruti can say. Grammatically, it is Adhumakam. So, Adhumakam Jyotiki Iva. You have to understand Adhumakaha is equal to Adhumakam. So, Adhumakam Jyotiki Iva. So, Angushtamatra Purushaha Jyotiki Iva Adhumakam. Adhumakaha is equal to Adhumakam. Adhumakam is Duma. It is Dhumakha. The Ka is there. Ka is a Pratyaya. Bahuri Samasa, you will see. And it's Kapratya. Bahuri Samasa. So, referring to that which doesn't have smoke. Avidyamanam Dumam Yasya Saha Adumakam. Adumaka. Adumakam. Duma is absent in which? Avidyamanam. Avidyamanam is Navidyamanam, not there. What? Duma. So, avidyamanam dhumam. Yasmin or yasya saha. Adhumakam. So, that adhumakam, the word is yuktam. It is proper. Why? Jyotihi paratvat. Jyoti follows. Paratvat means follows. Jyoti follows. Jyoti follows what? Jyoti follows what? Adhumaka. So, adhumaka, it follows adhumaka means jyoti is the substantive and adhumaka is adjective. Being adjective, therefore, it must qualify with the following word, paratvat. Jyotihi paratvat adhumakasya adhumakam yuktam. Vashakara gives grammatical interpretation. Grammar point. Grammar point for the word adhumaka here. Paratvat means follows. Now the next line. Yastvevam.
Yastvevam.
Yastvevam means yaha tu evam yastvevam. Sandhi we know. Lakshitaha.
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 Yogi bihi hridaye.
Yogi bihi hridaye.
This hridaya is the sandhi. Then you split hridaye. Ishanaha.
Ishanaha.
Bhutabhavyasya.
Bhutabhavyasya.
Saha nityaha kutastaha.
Saha nityaha kutastaha.
Adya idanim.
Adya
idanim.
Pranishu vartamanaha.
Pranishu vartamanaha.
Savu shvaha api vartishyate.
Savu shvaha api vartishyate.
Yaha tu evam. Yaha lakshitaha, the one who is lakshitaha, the one who is lakshita, lakshita by whom? Yogi bihi. Lakshita, here you can take it the meaning as the one who is, who, what is yaha lakshitaha yogi, that which is the lakshya of the yogi. If you take meaning of the yogi to be the upasaka, the meditators, so that what is lakshita by the upasakas, that. Yaha, saha, that. What is that? That purushaha. That jat jyotihi. That purushaha. That becomes the lakshita. That becomes the object of meditation. So, yaha yogi bhi lakshitaha. That which is lakshitaha, which is recognized, which is visualized, which is meditated by the yogi bhi. Yogi bhi yaha lakshitaha. Yaha lakshitaha var hridaye, in the heart. So, the meaning is yogi bihi hridaye lakshitaha. By the yogis, in the hridaya kuga, it is meditated. Yaha lakshitaha, what is meditated? What is meditated? That, what is that? Saha, that is Ishanaha, the Lord. So, here, the Angushta Matraha, what the mantra says in this mantra as well as in the previous mantra, as we said before, it is for for meditation. Meditation, the Upasana is not for moksha. It is not for Atma Jnana, it is only for some Adrishta Palam. Doing Upasana like this, it will give some better Palam. Maybe better Loka, Brahma Loka. That is what the Nachiketa Agni, which Vimadharmaraja taught to Nachiketa, that Agni which is combined with Upasana, it will give Svarga Loka Palam. Or if it is done with Nishkama, then it will give Chitta Shuddhi. Chitta Shuddhi for what? For Moksha Prapti. So, if it is done without any Kama, if it is Nishkama Upasana, then it will give Chitta Shuddhi. If it is Sakama Upasana, then it will give Palam. Accordingly, it will give Palam. Surga Loka Palam or whatever may be the Palam. So in that Upasana, that Angushta Matra Purushaha is like the Jyoti without the smoke. So to be meditated upon like that. And therefore, Yogi Bihi Yaha Lakshitaha Hridaye Saha Ishanaha, that Lord, who is Bhuta Bhavyasya, who is the Lord of the past, Bhuta Vartamana Api, we have to supply Vartamanasya Api. Bhuta Vartamana Bhavyasya Api Ishvaraha. Saha Eva Nityaha. He is Nityaha, he is Kutastaha. The word Nityaha, already we have seen Nityaha Kutastaha. Nityaha, that which is permanent, that is free from time, Kala Ragitaha, Trika, free from death, doesn't disappear in time. Therefore, it is Kutastaha, changelessly permanent. The two types of permanency. That is, one is changelessly permanent, other one is permanent with change. Changingly permanent, other one is changelessly permanent. Maya is changingly permanent. The Ishvara Upadhi Maya, which is changingly permanent. And the Kutastha Chaitanyam is changelessly permanent. So, therefore, Parinama Nityatvam and Kutastha Nityatvam. Kuta Nityatvam, two types of Nityatvam is there. The Veda also, Veda has got Pravaha Nityatvam. All the Vedas which came from the Lord in the beginning of the Srishti, they go back to the Lord and again it comes back. Again it comes back in the next Srishti. At the end of the Pralaya, it goes back to the Lord. Again it comes back at the beginning of the next Srishti. So, undergoes changes. Maya undergoes changes. That is why it's Maya. And Maya undergoes changes. But it is Nitya. That which doesn't undergo change and it is Nitya, that is Atma. Therefore, Nityaha Kutastaha. Vashishthara says that Nityaha is to dismiss, to rule out the Maya. It is Nityaha Kutastaha. Changelessly it is permanent. That which is changelessly, it is permanent. Why? Because this Upadhi, this Sharira Upadhi, which is there now, it will not be there tomorrow. Again it will come. Again it will come. What will happen to this Shariram? This Shariram will dissolve into Panchabhuta. Again the same Panchabhuta will combine and will give rise to Shariram. The Shariram which disappeared, went back to its source. Again it comes back in some other form. So therefore changingly present. Atma is not like that. It is Nitya Kutastaha. It is changelessly present in the changingly permanent Upadhi. So therefore, Nityaha Kutastaha Iti, and that which is present in all the Jivas, the Pranis, Adya, now, Pranishu Vartamanaha, Adya, Idanim Vartamanaha, Sarveshu, Pranishu, Vartamanaha, Yaha, Saha, Shaha Api Vartishyate, Bhavishyat, Bhavishyati. Saha api Bhavishyati. It continues to be there tomorrow also. It continues to be there tomorrow also where in the Pranishu. Sarveshu Pranishu. Saha api Vartishyate Bhavishyati Eva. Therefore, Saha Ishanaha Purushaha. Therefore, the idea is, the next line it conveys the idea. Why today and tomorrow? Na anyaha tat.
Na anyaha tat.
Samaha anyascha janishyate ityartaha.
Samaha anyascha janishyate
ityartaha. Na anyaha tat samaha. We have to stop like that. Na anyaha tat samaha. Anyascha janishyate. Anyaha tat samaha. Another one equal to that. Anyaha, another one. Tat samaha equal to that. Equal to what? Equal to Atma. Na anyaha, not equal. Not equal to that. That referring to Atma. Anyaha cha janishyate. There is nothing equal. There is nothing equal to that now. And there is nothing equal to that will be born in the future. Janishyate api. So there is nothing equal to Atma. There is nothing equal to Atma. Tat samaha. Atsanaha is Atmanaha Sanaha na Anyaha Asti Adya Idani. Anyaha cha Janishyate api. Nothing will be equal to Atma in future also. That is, nothing will be born equal to Atma. Ityartaha. Therefore, the same Atma is present now and the same will be present in the future. Body changes, but Atma continues to be the same. It is Nityaha Kutastaha iti. Therefore, that is the idea. With this, we will stop. The last line we can read. We can read in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidham Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.
धन्यवाद
जी, धन्यवाद
जी,
धन्यवाद।